One short video for the DAZA engine. This is the ethanol sensor for the content. 1 second. Okay, so let me show you what I did. The owner is here, that's why. So it's coming together with these fittings, right?
Yes.
These fittings. Open these fittings to see. This is what was have inside the box. Alright? So that's what I fixed. I was planning to crimp it. I was planning here to crimp it. But like this will never gonna come out.
Okay. This all is right? Better, yeah?
This is better. I'm gonna show you exactly what I put and why I put this one. Alright. You are putting ethanol, you need to spray more fuel, right?
Yes.
So see the inner diameter of this pipe. You see how small it is?
It is small.
Alright.
Yeah.
Let me show you what I put. What I put on the there, what I installed. I have here this one. That's exactly what I put. Okay, now compare this one, what I put with this one.
Yeah, it is.
Get my point? 1 second, let me turn it on. You see the difference?
Exactly, yeah.
So this is to don't block the flow. Because pressure, but you're not gonna have a flow if you put this one. You get my point?
Yes.
So that's why I put this one. Plus, when it comes inside of the rubber, this, it bites. You see how hard it's,
oh, yeah,
it's
yeah.
Very
this
sharp.
Is bigger.
Yeah.
This is smaller.
Exactly. This is smaller, this is bigger. I didn't use the clamps. If you want, take also this one. Take also this too, for spare, just in case. Just in case, get also this. I have plenty. There is no problem. Keep it together with the rest of the parts. Yeah. This one, if you want my opinion, don't use it anywhere. I don't have this size, honestly. And I don't want to have this size because wherever you're gonna put on the fuel system, this one, you'll get to use the flow, you know?
Okay.
4 millimeter in definitely. You know, and plus the sensor has a bigger hole. So why to put the small one instead of putting this one? You see how nice it is? I'm gonna like to crimp this one. I didn't crimp it. I use the clamp, and if you see this clamp, it's exactly on the bolt. It's not like the clamp what has inside. If I use, if I use this clamp, you see how big it is,
yeah,
this one?
Exactly.
So if you start tightening this clamp, what's gonna happen? Here you have a flat spot, and here it's gonna be round. It's not gonna be perfect round, you know? But this clamp, it's perfect round all the way around.
Clean job.
It's gonna be much more clean if it was crimped like this. That's why I brought that guy here for the crimping. 1 second, let me show you. Whoop! You see, he has the crimping tools here, all the pipes, everything. All right. Usually we are crimping. I open for you the door. I'm sorry.
Yes.
Just to show him. All right. Usually we are crimping, but if I crimp this pipe. This
break.
Is not stainless steel, it's not gonna break, it's gonna close the inner diameter.
Okay.
You know the point?
Okay.
So we're gonna end up from this big one to be like the small one. And again, we're not going anywhere. If you remove. Guys! Shut the fuck up! Thank you. So, if you remove the clamp and you try to remove the rubber, it won't come out. I try already.
Okay.
I said I don't care, I'm gonna destroy one of these because I have more, you know, and I try to pull it out without the clamp. It's not coming out.
I'm
saying it's not coming out. If you want to remove it for AB reason, the only thing what you have to do is to get the fuel line from this one to this one, and that's it.
Oh, okay.
You know the point? You don't have to remove and then make connection all these things. You're just purchasing one fuel line, and that's it. The brackets, it's back in place. Here and here, the cable is passing like this from down, right?
Mm.
Inside, it's not being grabbed everywhere, anywhere. So, nice and clean. Regarding the valve springs, you know.
When the oil, by the way.
Yeah.
1550, the sound became very less.
Yeah, like that's why I told you, man. Yeah. Here, you see what temperatures we have. I check also the oil filter. I check also the oil filter. On 540 it's thin oil.
Exactly.
On idle it does have the same pressure.
Yeah.
1550 has more pressure. So what I said to, I don't want to say the name, what I said to the other guy,
okay.
I said, check with the tuner if he can, from the software, I don't know if he can control the solenoid for the oil pump,
okay.
To increase on idle the oil pressure or to increase the idle by 100 RPMs. One second. So what I said, if you can increase the idle by 100 RPMs, it's going to be better for the coolant flow and for the oil flow.
50 max.
50 RPMs more.
Max.
It's going to help. It's going to help because it's going to increase the oil pressure.
Okay.
But see if you can control also the solenoid for the oil pump. You know? Because it's a variable. So you're going to increase a little bit the pressure.
Okay.
With a 10.6 or 15.50, you're never going to have a problem. Guaranteed. Not only this engine, I have another TTRS, M156, M177, BMWs, Volkswagen, Audi. In any case, I never faced a problem. I was have an engine that I opened it after 76,000 kilometers with a 10W60.
Okay.
If you see the bearings, like a brand new. You know? We change it to upgrade the piston connections and this kind of stuff. So, you have to, because later on, if you want to rev higher, and if you want to put a bigger turbo, you need to have a harder valve springs. That's it. Thank you very much. One small update. That's it. Thank you.